from 8 out of 10 Cats, The Countdown. John Locke, Joe Wilkinson, Danny Dyer, Gabby Logan, David O'Dougherty, Susie Gates, and Rachel Riley. Now, give your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, William the Conqueror tried to learn to speak English at the age of 43 but failed, a bit like Danny Dyer. The acronym OMG was first used 100 years ago. Hashtag you doth surprise me, Ricketts face, pox face. And if you mouth the words elephant shoes, it looks like you're saying, I love you. Try it at home. It's great for people who can't stand their partner but still want them to put out. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up is Sean Locke. Sean has a very distinctive look, and that look is the before photo in all hair rejuvenation adverts. And joining Sean tonight, it's Danny Dyer. Danny is an incredible actor. Whether he's playing an East End gangster, a Cockney wide boy, or an Essex hard nut, he can turn his hand to anything.
Sure.
Danny is on the latest series of Who Do You Think You Are? The show traces his family from poverty and crime in the East End all the way back through the centuries to poverty and crime in the East End. We should do Danny Dyer jokes. Yeah. They're a lot of fun. And up against them this evening is special guest team captain Joe Wilkinson. A loner who seems a bit weird and keeps himself to himself is how his neighbours will no doubt describe him when he's eventually caught. And Joe's teammate, Gabby Logan. Gabby has just returned from presenting the Olympics in Rio. I love the Olympics, whether I'm watching a drugged-up Russian jumping in a sandpit, a woman with testicles running really fast, or a Chinese slave child doing a forward roll. The Olympics has got something for everyone. Gabby, it's your first time on the show. Are you going to be better at the letters or the numbers?
I don't know. We're probably fairly average at both. But I know Joe will guide me through with his masterful...
Yeah, it's a piece of piss.
Use of the English language, I was going to say.
Now, Gabby, you used to be an international gymnast. Are you a sore loser?
I kind of beat myself up a little bit.
Would Joe make a good gymnast, do you think?
I think he's probably secretly quite strong underneath that brown suit.
Well, I don't think it's secret. Yeah, I'm very strong, very bendy as well.
Oh, yeah. That's what...
I can get through the railings in Alton Towers.
Right, Sean, let me ask you this. What's the worst lie you've ever told?
So many lies to choose from, aren't there? They're the ones, you know, normally I lie when I'm looking in prams or... As a parent, you lie. You say, like, you know, you watch too much telly, you get square eyes, your eyes are bigger than your belly. You can be anything you want to be. Lying, though, isn't it? You've got to lie. You live by your lies, don't you? There's an entire industry based on lies. I mean, we're in show business. Your teeth are a lie. There's that lie I told the American tourist. I said it's 998. Oh, yeah. That's funny. Well, I assume it was funny. I didn't stick around. I just left. Yeah.
Now, Danny, you're obviously a good-looking fella. You're a sort. Would you ever consider plastic surgery?
Nah.
Okay.
No, I quite like the idea of getting old. You know what I mean? I don't mind. You know what I mean? Sitting there in a little rocking chair, great big Derby about me. You know, Derby Kelly's a belly.
Who's Derby Kelly?
Get done out at this point. Old pipe out the old mouth, you know what I mean? It's a game I'm in, I think.
Yeah. So you look at Sean and think, great Christmas future.
Yeah, but I don't mind it, you know, getting old. That's it, get wiser.
I think it was an actor as well. You get older, you get more interesting parts, as a, you know. You're good.
Yeah.
Yeah, those stair lift commercials. Bath's got a door in it.
I've actually had a bit of... I don't really say this very often, but I've had a little bit of work done. Yeah, I had rice put into my buttocks. So when I twerk, I sound like a maraca.
Joe, have you got a mascot on today?
Yeah, I couldn't really think of anything, so I've brought quite a boring mascot with me. It's just a sort of bog-standard family picture. It's like one of many. Nice. It's actually the one I have in my downstairs lab. It's over there. That's my Uncle Mick and Auntie Pam. They run a B&B in Lowestoft. Cousin Ricky, he's got a clean driving licence. How many people can say that nowadays? half brother Fabio. yeah, it's just bog standard. Yeah.
What, why have all your family got balaclavas on?
I don't know, I've never asked them. And these two here, they're actually my nan and granddad, and coincidentally, tonight is their 60th anniversary.
Oh. So,
and I've actually, well, I've got a picture of them on their wedding day.
Oh, they haven't changed a bit.
No. Sorry, I said I wouldn't cry. Sorry.
OK. Joe, how will you celebrate if you win tonight?
If I win tonight, I'll probably just go out for a quiet meal with the family, because, you know, a few of them are in tonight.
Beautiful table. Beautiful table.
Gabby, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I have.
What have you got?
I've got my my lucky towel.
OK. Why is the towel lucky? Because you made your top out of it?
When I was a kid, I was a gymnast, and so before you go on the mat, your hands get a bit sweaty and a bit nervous, you know? Your hands get a bit clammy. So you always have a towel that you dry your hands with.
Right.
And to cut a long story short, I once had a Chinese teacher, and she was told us all about Chinese customs and that red was a lucky colour. So I thought, I'll make my towel red, and that'll bring me luck. And so for my whole gymnastics career, my lucky towel came everywhere. And I did British Championships, and I did the best I'd ever done. And the next day, I was flying to Auckland for the Commonwealth Games. And I arrived in Auckland, and I'd left my lucky towel in Milton Keynes. But I just convinced myself for 3 weeks that I didn't need the towel.
Did you do OK?
No, I did really badly.
That's going to bring you good luck.
Yeah. And if it doesn't, we can make matching balaclavas
I'd
out.
Love, I'd love that.
Yeah, so, and we can sit together and cuddle up.
Probably should have washed it, but...
OK, Danny, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, now... It's a tortoise. Now, you know I'm not a scientist, Jim, right, but...
Thanks for clarifying.
Just, you know, like, these fascinate me, these things, right? Now, I don't know if it's true or not, but I heard, like, their shell, you can shoot it, right? Whack it with an hammer, wouldn't break it, chuck his little nut in. You could, like, you couldn't eat it, but if you flip it over like that, it dies. Like within half hour, it gets all stressed out, can't deal with it, right? So if a fox come along, a little clever fox just flipped it over, give it half hour cooking time, and then it could munch it out of a bowl. I'm hoping.
It's the only animal that serves itself.
I'm hoping. I feel sorry for it in a way. I think God's a liberty. If he's created a creature you cannot penetrate, but if you flip it over, it's fact. You know, I'm fascinated by him, so that's my little lucky thing. Like, look at it, weird-looking thing. Do I just plot it there, or is it going to wind people up?
Yeah, stand on mine now.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I do, Jimmy.
What have you got?
Well, I've got some more of a tribute, actually. I'd like to say goodbye to someone who's, you know, been close to me in the past. This is Budgie that died in a taxidermy accident. We thought he was asleep. A big sleeper. He's always asleep. That's why it's called Dozy. This time it had gone on a bit too long. He was taking the piss, really. sleeping for a good week. But I thought that was it for a dozy. And then one day, right, I saw one of these things hovering near my window. And I thought, maybe I could give Dozy a proper send-off to make up for the times that I neglected him. And I thought it'd be a nice tribute. And they say to me, oh, you can have anything you want. I said, well, I'd like this. I'd like to... Ooh.
Well, don't panic, he's already dead.
Well, yeah, but dignity is important. So,
oh,
and I've chosen his favourite song, so if we can have that. Oh, <that's> so... Oh! I know. Oh, Joe, I'll hold him there. Just hold it there, guys.
That could not have gone any worse.
That was a disaster.
Hang on, Rachel's picking up with two cards. It's not. Is it Zinnard's?
It is a real dead budgie, isn't it?
I stuffed it, but in a hurry. I'll put it next to the tortoise.
Shut up on earth.
Sure.
Oh, there you go, look. Pop a little pals.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's David O'Doherty. I'm not saying David O'Doherty looks like he sells the big issue, but if he was a card game, he'd be Top Tramps. If he was running for president in America, he'd be Donald Trump. And if your kids were jumping up and down on him in the garden, he'd be a trampoline.
At least they don't look like a vampire who's temping like you.
David, here's a question for you. What's your favourite way to waste time?
I do quite a lot of that. So, I guess sport. I'll go to sports that I don't even know the rules of. I was in Australia and I'd go to Aussie Rules. And because I didn't have a team or know what the rules were, I'd just pick the animal mascot that would win if there was a fight. So if it was like the tigers against the kangaroos, you're like, well, obviously the tigers are going to ruin the kangaroo. But then it'd be like the tigers against the bombers, like, well, the bombers will smash the habitat of the tigers. But then I went to a tricky one, so it was the Dockers against the Blues. And like, who's got, because like people who work down the wharf are notoriously tough, but then depression can defeat anyone. So it's, it's a tricky situation.
Okay. With David, of course, is Susie Dent. Susie is so versatile. Not only is she on TV, she's also a successful author and radio broadcaster. So if you're a fan of watching something boring, reading something boring, or hearing something boring, she's got it covered. Susie, do you have a celebrity crush?
Well, Danny, obviously. I wouldn't say weird, although he called me his weird crush, famously, once.
No, but I deny that there's nothing weird about you at all.
Oh, I think...
Well, you hardly know her.
That's true. So, yes, Danny on the one hand, and then you'll laugh at this, Gabby, but Arsene Wenger would be on the other side, probably. I mean, that's a bit strange.
Well, I think we've got a picture of Arsene Wenger.
No, he's very charming.
Yeah, they get to go quite well together. Arsene is incredibly clever. Sorry, Danny. He's very clever. speaks lots of languages. Mm. And Danny's the brawn. So I'd say two, yes, two celebrity crushes. Yeah.
To be fair, it would be a mad threesome, that, wouldn't it?
OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel, I'm not saying there's been a mix-up in wardrobe, but whenever I see you do the numbers, I can't help but wonder if there's a girl doing Jaeger bombs in a Wetherspoons dressed as a librarian. Lots of people would be jealous of your abilities with maths, but if you could swap brains with anyone here this evening, who would it be?
I think I would have to go for Joe Wilkinson.
I wouldn't. There's a lot of dark shit up here.
Well, yeah. I mean, I've got strong suspicions that he's been breaking the terms at the court set.
Yeah, we normally Joe is over there with you, but because of the restraining order,
exactly,
we had to...
Yeah. Yeah. They measured it out. They actually moved this back a little bit just so we could get away with the programme.
Yeah. You know, I'm prepared to do a bit of time.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Keytar. OK, let's count then, everyone. Time for the first game. Joe and Gabby, you get the first pick of the letters.
Yeah, yeah, do you want to choose? I'm going to have a little rest.
Vowel.
Thank you, Gabby. E.
Another vowel, please.
A.
Consonant.
G.
Another consonant.
R.
Another vowel, please.
O.
A consonant.
L.
And another consonant.
T.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And another consonant, please.
And the last one. F.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. Ah!
Gary, how did you do?
Okay, I was only six.
True.
Yeah.
Okay, Joe?
Mine's six as well. I just, yeah, mine's
okay.
Six.
Okay. Sean, how many?
I only got five.
Danny?
Seven, but I feel I've spelt it wrong.
Sean, what's yours?
Gloat.
Gloat, okay. Gabby, you're six.
What? What's wrong with that?
What's wrong with what?
That's what you
think. Oh, yeah. Oh,
I think he's got seven.
All right, I did it up.
Gabby, what's your six?
Toiler.
Toiler. Joe, what's yours?
Grafter.
Grafter.
Mm. I haven't got two R's, I don't think.
Oh, you idiot! You're that confident!
You wrote it down.
Danny, you're seven?
Yes, bollocks. a freighter. You know, like a freighter train.
Like a freighter train.
I
was going to say how are you spelling that, but how are you pronouncing that? Hotel. Okay, 6 points to Gabby. Okay, David, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, they could have done a little bit better. Keeping with the toilet theme, we've got a few. Foliage is a seven-letter word, which is used to describe sheets of toilet paper. Gloater.
It was toiler, not toilet.
What was it, toiler?
Toiler, yeah.
Okay. It wasn't toilet. My analogy got it's really ruined now.
Sorry.
But I'll stay with it.
Yeah.
Gloater, which is what you do after you've toiled for a whole day. You're happy with all the toiling. And then floatier is a poo that won't flush.
OK, so at the end of that, Joe and Gabby are in the lead with six. On to our first numbers round. OK, Sean and Danny, you get the pick of the numbers.
I don't like getting involved in this one.
OK. Two from the top and the usual recipe, please.
Thank you, Sean. Two from the top and four from the bottom. Okay. And these little ones, 4, 2, 5, 1. And the big ones, 175. And the target, 686.
OK, so your target is 686. Your time starts now.
Thank you.
Okay, Danny, I can't help but notice you did not take part
in the
numbers
round. Getting involved in it. It upsets me. I just don't want anything to do with it. Just swerve me on this one, please.
Okay, Sean, what did you get? The target was 686.
I got 678.
Near enough. Okay. Joe, how did you do?
Genuinely 600. 667 and a half.
Okay, it was interesting. Gabby, how did you do?
Really not well. I got 678 as well.
Okay, how did you get 678, Gabby?
I got 678 by timesing 9 times 75 and adding on 1 plus 2.
How the hell do you know 9 times 75?
And how did you get your 9? Just
5 plus a 4.
Yeah,
sorry, you're sorry. In. Sorry.
Times 75, 9, yeah. Or 675, and then the 1 and the 2.
Is that how you got it?
Mm.
Yeah.
Well, that's...
I believe you.
5 points to Gabby and Sean. Rachel, can it be done?
Yeah, it was so close to that. 5 plus 4 is 9, but then 75 plus 1, 76. Oh. Times those together for 684 and add the 2.
Oh.
OK, so Sean and Danny have 5, Joe and Gabby have 11.
Yes.
OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. David O'Doherty, what have you got for us?
I've got the party machine, everyone. Ooh. I thought I would do a song. I thought, actually, tonight I've written a duet, but unfortunately I wrote it for me and Shakira. It's great that Susie's here, so I'd like you to do your best. I've got some South American instruments, Susie, so when I call upon you, just percussion away, and I'll be taking care of the me and Shakira part, so hopefully no one notices. It's a rainy night, I lie in bed, tucked up and warm. Out of the storm. What's that? A knock at the door. Who could it be? I run down to see, and there, soaked to the skin, stands a tiny woman. To get here to you, thinking of specific things that I'd like to do. So come on, let's not waste all day. I am Shakira, let's get busy. I'll be honest, I'm filled with questions more than anything else. The first one being, Shakira, are you sure that you've got the right address? Yes, I am, David, and soon your balls I will caress. Shakira, how do you even know who I am? I watch your videos on YouTube, your albums in my van. You have a van, a brown transit van. Here. But Shakira, just to think this might be some weird obsessive crush in your part that's gone awry. David, look at my hips, they do not lie. Can you do a pan pipe so? Just do a little pan pipe so, just do anything. And I think Shakira understands, having heard that. She goes, now I completely see the point you're making. This isn't going to work, Shakira. Even though my tiny Colombian heart is breaking, I'll walk away and you forever miss. Please don't ever tell anyone about this. I say, no, of course not, Shakira. Maybe just this one time on Countdown. Hit that.
Susie Jen there on the panpipes with David O'Doherty. And here is your teaser. The words are girth fan. The clue is, makes me think of grandma. That's girth fan, makes me think of grandma. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease. The words were girth fan. The clue was, makes me think of grandma. It was, of course, farthing. OK, so Joe and Gabby are in the lead. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Danny and Joe.
Yes.
So, I mean, no winners, really. Danny, your turn to choose the letters.
I'll have a couple of vowels, please.
We just do
Danny.
Three.
Do what?
We just do three.
You.
Three letters, that's
just
all.
Just do that. Oh, well, I'm up with that.
One more, and then
it's a consonant.
C.
Yeah, that'll do.
Another consonant then. Oh, no. Said one more,
we'll
see what happens.
Four. Yeah, there we go.
T.
Shit's nothing there.
Oh, bollocks.
It's
cute. It's
vowel.
Cute. We can get an N, that'd be lovely.
I.
Another consonant, please.
Oh.
Come on, no one cares. We just want an end.
Cut the valves. It's a cut of vowels and another consonant. I don't know the difference. It's another vowel and one more consonant.
We get an N, I've got a 7. I don't want to do it now.
And your time starts now. OK, Danny, how many?
I've got 7.
What?
OK, Joe, how did you do?
I've got 6.
6. What was your 6?
Bather.
Bather. It's ironic that you would have bather.
Yeah,
go on, what's your 7, then?
Haircut.
Haircut. You didn't even need the H. 7 points to Danny Dyer. David, Susie, could they have done any better than 7?
No, 7 was that's the best, you... I have to say.
OK. Sean, what are you up to?
Oh, no.
What are you doing?
Well, I don't just have... one dead bird I need a... This one died in what I can only describe as suspicious circumstances. I was gardening, that's all I'm just saying. As he died, he looked me in the eye and he just said, one more flight. That's all I want.
He said that?
Well, in his eyes. And I was just about to chuck him over a wall. When I saw one of these coming past. And I...
Well, you're very good at these.
I thought, I'll go on a course, I'll get proficient, and forget the music, please, just to set the mood.
Lean on me when you're not strong.
See you,
the
buddy.
Final flight.
See you, you rancid piece of vermin, blessed with flight. Mom.
OK, so at the end of that, Joe and Gabby have 11, Sean and Danny have 12. Yeah. Right, now time for Sean and Gabby to go head-to-head. Gabby, your turn to pick the numbers.
Rachel, can you choose the numbers, please?
I will go for the Sean special, the 2 from the top, and 4 little. Right,
yeah. Sure.
4 little, okay. 8, 9, 5, 2, and the big ones, 25 and 100. And the target, cool. 240.
Okay, your time starts now. OK, so the target was 240. Gabby, did you get it?
No, I got 245.
245. OK, 5 away. Sean, did you get it?
Yeah, I got 241. Well, I got 241.
241. OK, how did you get 241?
2 plus 8.
2 plus 10, 8, 10.
Times 25.
250.
Minus 9.
Well done.
Yeah, gets hold of that.
OK, 7 points for Sean. Rachel, could it be done?
Yeah, I think DAD might have it.
Yeah!
Yeah. Well, go ahead, DOD. You get involved.
Do you want the pen and everything?
Okay. Oh, look at his tiny little legs. This will take him a while.
There you go.
So, the key to it is obviously staying within the grid. So, what should I do? 100. If you give me a shit pen.
There you go.
Thank you.
Yeah.
By two.
It's all going to pot over here, David.
Is 200. Five by eight is 40, giving us 240. Whoa!
9.5 instead of 8.5.
Gabby's very cross. She.
I did 9.5s instead of 8.5s.
So she punched me.
I'm starting to question how lucky that towel really is. OK, so Joe and Gabby have 11, Sean and Danny have 19. Oh. OK, time to go across now to Literary Corner. David, what have you got for us?
I've got, I mean, this is a poignant evening for me, Susie, because this, like, I love this show. I love it. But this is the last time I'm ever going to be on it, because this time next year, I'm going to be huge! Way too big for this small, tiny nerd bullshit! This time next year, there won't be a venue capable of holding my crowd. I'll have two gigs from a hot air balloon over the center of the country with a loudhailer and a Dyson just hoovering up money. This time next year, my fragrance will be everywhere. Boner Owner by David O'Doherty. That's what it's called. I'm expecting money. Boner Owner. That's the ad. This time next year, I'm going to be a real arsehole. Like, I'm not too bad now. Ask me how I am. Susie, ask me how I am. This is me right now. Ask me how I am.
David, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. That's me now. But let's wind the clock forward a year, though, and see how I've changed. So this is this time next year. Danny, ask me how I am.
How are you?
Go fuck yourself! Leave me alone! This time next year, Kanye West will describe people as having gone a bit O'Doherty. You know what I mean? This time next year, when we come back here just to shoot a documentary about how shit my career used to be. That's this time next year. But then the year after next, I'll be back here again. It won't work out. This is as big as this ever gets. And I'll be like, please, producers, have me back on the show. And you'll all be like, ah. Like the former X Factor finalist's first day back at Tesco. And everyone's like, ah. We knew you'd be back because your music's shit. For your first job, can you shovel copies of your own CD into the crusher? Because nobody will ever want it. This time next year and the year after next. But in the meantime, it's a delight to be here.
David Doherty. OK, the scores at the moment. Joe and Gabby have 11. Sean and Danny, you're in the lead with 19.
Oof.
And here is your teaser. The words are Nips Rise. The clue is that gives me an idea. That's Nips Rise that gives me an idea. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were Nips Rise. The clue was that gives me an idea. It was, of course, Inspires. OK, before we get on with the game, time for a quick bonus round, a chance for our teams to win some extra points. In honour of the great Danny Dyer, we've got a quiz all about Danny. So I've got some questions, Danny. You'll be able to provide the answers. OK. So the first question in the Danny Dyer quiz. Can you guess the missing word in this tweet? Gonna watch a bit of blank while munching on a toasted crumpet that's absolutely pissing with Marmite. Sophistication. So what do you think the missing word is?
Pisses right through, though, right onto the plate. You know what I'm saying? Proper pissing through. That's a crumpet. That's how you eat a crumpet, in my eyes.
OK, so what do you think the missing word is?
Ballet?
Ballet. You think he's watching ballet? OK. Joe?
I put Taggart.
OK, Sean?
Question time.
Danny, what was the answer?
Political.
It's question time, yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
The answer is question time.
And also, wants to know what's going on.
Have you ever been on Question Time, Danny?
No, they won't have me on there for some reason. I've no idea why.
Tell you why. Bunch of slags. OK, next question. What's the missing word in this tweet? If we didn't have blank, we could never enjoy eating a sandwich.
This one, easy. Yes. It's obvious.
OK, Gabby, what have you written down?
Baps.
If we didn't have Baps, we could never enjoy eating a sandwich. OK, Joe?
I'll put a mouth.
You make a strong case. Sean?
Chairs. Can't eat sandwich standing up.
Danny, what was the answer?
Thumbs.
Half a point. Half a point.
Sorry, no. Yeah, because if you didn't have any thumbs, you'd be fat.
Sorry, what?
I rolled it. I was wrong.
No, no, quite right. Right.
Good. And I'm glad you shared that with the nation.
OK, question number three in the Danny Dyer bonus quiz. This is an interesting fact about Danny. Why does Danny think he's middle class? OK, so why does Danny believe, incorrectly, that he is middle class?
I want to be fucking middle class.
Well, you thought you were.
Well, I was for a bit out there.
Right, why does Danny believe he is middle class? Gabby?
Because he has thumbs.
Joe?
I've put, because he's got a pull-out dining room table.
Sean, what have you got?
Small telly.
He thinks he's middle class because he has a small telly.
Well, yes. A big telly. The more money you've got, the bigger telly.
No, there's a certain point at which you go posh and just have a little telly.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Danny, why do you believe yourself to be middle class?
Because my wife bought cinnamon-scented toilet paper once. So I was wiping my arse and my arse smelt of cinnamon. So I thought... I thought that was quite middle class. I kept getting a little hint of it now and again, a little twang of it. I thought, oh, yeah.
They do any other flavours, like Marmite?
Flavours?
I like the oxtail soup.
OK, well, Sean, you won the quiz, so that's 5 bonus points to you. OK, on with the game. Joe and Gabby, your turn to choose the letters.
consonant, please.
Thank you, Joe. N.
And then could I have a vowel, please?
I.
Consonant, please.
R.
And a vowel.
E.
Consonant.
C.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant, please.
D.
Consonant, please.
L.
It's Ireland! It's nearly Ireland!
What do we need? What do we need?
One more.
It's there, it's Ireland.
It's there!
It's there! Ireland's there.
Get the dancers back out!
I'll have a consonant, please.
And last
all I can speak bloody Ireland now.
OK, your time starts now. OK. Joe, how many?
I could only see Ireland.
OK, Gabby, how did you do?
7.
7?
Wow, very good.
Pretty good.
I don't know if mine's a real word.
OK. Sean, how many did you get?
6.
Danny?
I only got 4.
What was your 4?
Lean.
Should I put a C on the front?
Clean. Bollocks, yeah.
Sean, you're 6?
Cradle.
Cradle. Gabby, you're risky 7.
Go on, do it.
Cradler.
Oh, that's lovely.
Cradle. That's not work, surely not.
Yeah, someone a cradle.
That's a steward, that is.
Susie, then we're going to require a steward's inquiry.
Yeah, it's not there.
Ah! God damn it. What about Ireland?
Because when people play, like, games with nets and they're cradling... Mm. The ball, like in lacrosse, you cradle the ball. Would they not be a cradler?
Yeah.
That's the example of cradling a ball you can think of. OK, 6 points to Sean. David, Susie, I look to you.
Yeah, there's the 7s. There is carried, which is a 7 letter. Caroline, which is a...
thistle.
A thistle, of course. My favourite of all the thistles. And then randier is when you're more randy than someone else. Like, if there's two people called Randy, one of them is even more American.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Danny are in the lead with 30 points. And here's your final teaser. The words are toss race. The clue is don't leave any stains. That's toss race, don't leave any stains. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were toss race. The clue was don't leave any stains. It was, of course, coasters. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean and Danny, your turn to choose the letters.
Come on.
Right, I'm going to do it this time.
You do it, mate. You do it, boy.
Joe, Gabby, you need a nine-letter word here to do this. Nine letters, we double the score, you get 18, you're back in the game.
That's all of them, isn't it?
Yeah. All of them, but in a different order.
Close. That close.
Vowel, please.
Starting with E.
Consonant, please.
T.
Vowel.
O.
Oh, there's no...
consonant.
X.
Ah, fuff.
Oh, get rid of the X, get rid of the X. No-one likes the X. Yeah. Oh.
Did nothing.
Consonant, please.
W.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant, please.
T.
Consonant. Consonant, please, Rachel.
H.
Consonant, please.
L.
And I'll have a vowel, please.
And the last one, A.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now. Ooh.
Ah!
Okay, Danny, how many?
Five.
Sean, how many?
Just sixes.
Joe?
Nine.
Okay, Gabby?
Five.
I thought I had a nine, but there's just an E missing.
Okay, Gabby, what did you get?
Lathe.
Okay, Danny?
Wheat.
Wheat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, Sean, you're six?
Waffle.
Mm.
Yeah.
This thing.
That's a good
one. Yeah. I'm getting.
Joe, your nine-letter word.
It is risky. Eto Wattler.
Congratulations, Joe.
You're incredible.
How are you spelling that, Joe?
It's how it sounds.
It's phonetic.
E-T-O-W... Oh, is there a W? Yeah, there's a W. I thought there wasn't W there for a second.
hang on. She's just skipped one. Go at it with the pen cam. There is just... I think there's one.
OK, 6 points to Sean.
Sean's...
Could they have done any better, David, Susie?
I know, I think six was good.
Wattle is good.
OK, so Joe and Gabby have 11, Sean and Danny have 36.
11 is my lucky number.
Yeah. OK, what have we got to do now?
OK, you've got to just get the conundrum.
Oh. I can't do the... It genuinely makes me feel seasick.
OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's countdown conundrum. And your time starts now.
I'll piss off.
Suffering.
Oh.
Let's have a look and see if you're right. 4 seconds in.
Okay, Gabby.
So the final scores are Gabby and Joe have 11 points for the winners with an incredible 46, Sean and Danny. Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of this the countdown, Peter. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
It's Fight or Flight on Monday here on 4. The recruits are the most vulnerable they've ever been, apart from the last time that they were quite vulnerable. SAS Who Dares wins at 9. Hitting the beating heartland of the election next tonight, though, the fast turnaround one-man show, Michael Moore in Trumpland, coming up.